Hang on, hang on.
Clap your hands! Clap your hands! Clap your hands!
Clap Hello? Your hands. City Kids? It's me, Pastor B, coming at ya. Hey, hope you all are doing well. Listen, we have a great service prepared just for you. Today, you're going to hear about a king who failed, and how it revealed for all of God's people the need for a truer and better and a more perfect king, King Jesus. So we're going to learn about King Jesus. We're going to sing about King Jesus. You're going to hear about King Jesus, and I am going to see you on the other side. See you real soon. Bye.
Hey, City Kids. How you guys doing today? Hey, welcome to the Sing Song Sing Along. So today we are going to sing a couple songs. You ready to sing them? Mm-hmm. All right. Mm-hmm. We're going to do God is the Creator of Everyone and Everything, and we're going to sing the Lord's Prayer. So sing along with us. Here we go.
God is the Creator of everyone and everything. 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 Of everyone and everything. Everyone and everything, God is the Creator of everyone and everything. God is the Creator of everyone and everything. God is the Creator of everyone and everything.
One more time.
God is the Creator of everyone.
So you guys know the Lord's Prayer. We've sung it a couple times. Sing it with us.
Can you sing loud?
What is the Lord's Prayer?
Right here. Here we go.
Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we also have forgiven our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
All right, y'all sing really loud. Ready? Here we go.
Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we also have forgiven our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
See you guys. See you next time.
Thank you.
King Solomon loved God, but he did not love God with his whole heart. Solomon had hundreds of wives, and many of them were from other nations. Solomon's wives turned him away from God, and he began to worship the false gods that his wives worshiped. God was angry. God said to Solomon, "Since you have done this, I will take the kingdom away from you. You will be the king the rest of your life, but when your son becomes king, he will lose everything except for one tribe."
When Solomon died, his son Rehoboam became king. The people told Rehoboam, "Your father, Solomon, made us work too hard. We will gladly serve you if you make our work easier." Rehoboam thought about it and asked his father's friends for advice. "Be kind to the workers, and they will work for you forever," they said. But Rehoboam ignored that advice.
He asked his own friends what he should do. Rehoboam listened to his friends and told the workers, "My father did not make you work hard enough. I'll make you work even harder." The people did not want to serve a king like Rehoboam, so they made Jeroboam king. Jeroboam had been one of Solomon's officials. Now he was king of the northern kingdom of Israel. Only one tribe remained under Rehoboam's rule, and that was the southern kingdom of Judah.
Rehoboam did not like being king of only one tribe. He planned to attack the northern kingdom of Israel, but God sent a prophet to stop him. The prophet had a message from God. "Do not fight them. The people of Israel are part of your family. I am the Lord, and I am in control of what is happening." So Rehoboam went home.
Now, Jeroboam was the king of Israel, but he wasn't a good king. When the people of Israel traveled to Jerusalem to worship God at the temple, Jeroboam worried that they would start thinking of Rehoboam as their leader. So Jeroboam made two golden calves and told the people, "Going to Jerusalem is too difficult for you. Here are your gods who brought you up from the land of Egypt. You can worship them." What Jeroboam did was a sin. Those calves did not lead God's people out of Egypt. God led his people out of Egypt. Jeroboam led all the people to worship the false gods instead of the one true God.
King Solomon failed to lead God's people perfectly. God's people needed a better king, a perfect king. Through David's family, God would send his own son, Jesus Christ, to be a perfect king over God's people forever. Jesus is greater than Solomon. Jesus brings his people together and leads them back to God.
Good morning, City Kids. It's Miss Ashley here again with you on Sunday morning. And man, did our story take a turn that I wasn't completely ready for. Like last week, we went from the fact that Solomon was a really wise king and he built God's permanent house, the temple. He did so many great and wonderful things. And now, where do we find him, guys? He is a failed God, okay, just like his father David, just like Saul before him. They failed God. He listened to other people in his life, obeyed the things that they obeyed instead of listening to God and obeying him. And then what happened after that? His son, not that great of a king. The people were so mad. Their whole nation divided. They had two separate kings, right? They were on kind of like opposing sides. Do you ever find that that happens in our life today, where people just get on opposite sides of things and they don't see eye to eye? Like, I feel like I can think of something super simple, like what's the best ice cream, vanilla or chocolate, right? Everyone has an opinion about that. And, you know, in our family, one of the things we argue about where we kind of have some tension, where it kind of divides us, is on which pizza to order on Fridays, because we do Pizza Friday. So sometimes we make our own pizza. Sometimes we order from, in my opinion, the best pizza, Jets. Some people in my house like something else. I won't call them out, but it definitely divides us sometimes, even like what movie to watch on movie night, right? How many times you've been divided against maybe your sibling or your parent on which movie is the best movie to watch. People can be divided over all sorts of things. And we learned from today that that's nothing new, right? People have always been divided over things. We think we're so right about our opinion, or these people think they're so right about their opinion, right? The way they think things should be done. And the big problem with all of that division is so often we've lost the sight of God. We have lost the sight of His Son, Jesus. I mean, after all, what did Jesus come to do? He came to show us God's love. He came to bring His people back together, right? His people have been so divided from one another, so separated. He came to bring the people back together and lead them to God. So the really awesome thing about God that I get from this story is that, I don't know if you remember, but God made a covenant with David, right? That like the king, the ultimate king, the best king who would save God's people would come from David's family. And even though David failed God, Solomon failed God, Rehoboam failed God, like God fulfilled His promise, even though the people in the middle failed, right? That perfect king was Jesus. And God did that. He didn't keep it from happening because the people kept failing Him and kept dividing from one another. God still kept His promise that He made to all people and brought Jesus, the most perfect king, the most loyal king, the most kind king, the most just king. He was everything fully that we needed Him to be, and He still is. So remember, even though people might fail, people are going to be so divided. And they're going to be so divided, not over, I know some of the stuff I was talking about today was a little bit silly, but people get divided over really serious big things too. And even though that happens, God gave us Jesus. So I think what my whole point is in all of this is if you find yourself really divided with someone, especially one of God's followers, right? And even if it's a neighbor or a friend or a family member, but when you find yourself just so divided with someone, right? You want to separate, just like the Israelites did, and say, you get over here and I'll get over here and we can do things our own way. When you find yourself like that, remember who Jesus is. Remember who God is, right? Jesus came to bring His people back together and lead them back to God. So when you find yourself utterly divided from others, you can pray and ask Him for guidance on how to be united again together with His people, with your community, with your family, with your friends. Ask God for the wisdom on how to be back together again, how to find your way to God. Because our opinions are not what's the most important. Our way, like we think, I know how to do this, right? Just like David did. He thought he knew the best way to do something. Solomon thought he knew the best way to do something. Jeroboam, Rehoboam, all the leaders before, the leaders that are in power in our world today, they all thought they knew how to do something best. And the fact is, God knows how to do it best. So when you find yourself divided, my only request is that you would just pause and pray to God and ask Him for the wisdom on how to find unity, how to find your way back to Him so that your wants, your desires can be aligned with His wants and His desires. All right. I'm sorry to leave you in such a tense place in the life of the Israelites and their divided kingdom. But next week, we're going to start a new series all about this divided kingdom. And we're going to learn more about what happens to God's people as they wait for the return of Jesus. Or actually, they're not waiting for the return of Jesus. They're waiting for the first time He ever came. So stay tuned next week. And I can't wait to go kind of more on this journey with you guys. All right. Bye.
Hey, City Kids. Hope you enjoyed that worship service. Listen, your City Church family, we love you. Pastor B loves you. Our family loves you. And listen, you are loved most importantly by God. May you know that his joy, his love, his peace, it is all yours this week. May it go before you. I'll see y'all real soon.
Clap your hands!